Hi guys, I just saw Michael Jackson's Halloween special from last year. I thought it was really good. It seems like I picked up on more things this time than I did last time, but that's always the case when you see something twice. But there were a lot of things that dealt with the living dead, which is like one of Michael's favorite topics, the living dead, right? He's been doing Thriller with the zombies and the werewolves and the ghost. And even in Moonwalker, he was thought to have died and come back to life. So Michael's had this fascination with being the living dead for decades. So anyone that doesn't believe Michael wanted to fake his death, just point to his music. I'm going to do another video on all the music that's in my fair use documentaries that all have a transformative meaning. And that's why I'm able to use Michael's music. But that's going to be like maybe a video. Maybe I'll go live tomorrow. I don't know. I'm not going to promise, but I will do it soon. Hello, everybody. I wrote a lot of notes, but I know there were a lot of Michael Jackson things, you know, like the guy, Vincent, with his MJ shirt. That MJ logo appeared in that house, in this place, motel. So it did belong there. Hi, everybody, on a Saturday night. So I hope you guys all watched and supported and promoted Michael Jackson's Halloween, because I most certainly did. So, of course, we got the 7777 Jackson Street, but that's not necessarily a death hoax clue. I kind of want to just go over the things that deal with the death hoax, those kind of clues. So I counted 11 of them. And if I miss some, please feel free to let me know. And it has to be the MJ-related stuff is not necessarily death hoax, like how Victoria had the armband and Michael and his armband. That's not a death hoax clue. 777 is not necessarily a death hoax clue, but it's representative of Michael. So let's see, ravens, you know, like Edgar Allan Poe, who was like a king of hoaxes. So they dealt with the ravens and Edgar Allan Poe. Michael wanted to play him in a movie, but never got a chance to. So that has to do with hoaxes and the ravens, which are the birds. And then there were zombies three times, lots of zombies. And zombies are of course, the living dead. And let's see, spiders. You know, Michael likes spiders. He had spiders all the way back to where the Victory Tour. And then he got out of a spider in This Is It. Not necessarily a death hoax clue, but the zombies most certainly are. Ichabod! Death hoax clue. The dogs was named Ichabod. Ichabod is the name from Ichabod Crane from Sleepy Hollow, who was the living dead who resurrected. So that's one. The dog in the special was called Ichabod. So that's definitely a death hoax clue. And then we had, oh, the girl. Not only do we have the wink at the end, but the girl, Victoria, winks with a ding. That sounds just like my little ding in my Wink Wink Alive 3. Ding. She winks at Vincent at one point in the middle of the movie. And then we have the song Threatened. We have a lot of Michael music there, lots and lots. But all of them are not death hoax, but Threatened and Thriller most certainly are, because Threatened says he is the living dead. So that's a death hoax clue for sure. And P.T. Barnum, that has to do with hoaxes, P.T. Barnum, because they showed the Dangerous album and they had P.T. Barnum, very prominent there. He deals with hoaxes. Skeletons deal with the living dead, and there are lots of skeletons, and Michael loves skeletons, like in Ghost, loves living dead stuff. Zombies, there was a zombie commercial for the new LG phone. So there was a commercial with zombies in them here in Los Angeles. I don't know if it was nationwide. The live heads, all the heads in the jars, they were the living dead, the preserved heads in the jars. And then the cat, Catch the one with the cat, eight out of nine lives, how a cat has nine lives. So this cat was on number 8 out of 9 lives. And then I think, did the cat die on the 9th life? Maybe so. And then there is the dead coming back to life, like with the zombies and with Thriller, how the zombies come back to life. And we have the wink at the end. So there were a lot of death hoax clues in this. And let's see, a move while MJ. Oh, and then Michael says in his own voice, keep trying. Don't give up. Just believers in yourself. So we had all those wonderful clues, all those great clues that were in the Michael Jackson Halloween special. Somebody said the dancing Michael at the end looked different than last year's, but I would have to go back and look at last year's. If any of you missed it, you can Google it. And I think on Facebook in the group Michael Jackson Love, I saw that they were streaming it. So if you go to Michael Jackson Love on Facebook, you should be able to see it if anybody missed it. And and that's pretty much it. It's just going to be a very short one. So I hope you guys enjoyed it and you watched Michael Jackson's Halloween. And also, you never, ever, ever can forget my shameless plug. Okay. Because nobody else advertises it but me. So I have to. So don't forget to get your copy of the Alive Trilogy of Michael Jackson documentaries. Alive 1, Is Michael Jackson Really Dead? Was on Netflix from 2011 to 2013. And then I released Alive 2, The Great Escape, which is very technical. If anybody said, no, it's impossible, how did he do it? And they want to know the intellectual parts of how Michael faked his death, that's Alive 2. And then Alive 3 is, what has Michael been doing? Because if he's alive, he has to be somebody, right? So who could he possibly be? And what evidence do we have to prove that it's him, right? So I break that down in Alive 3. And for you guys, guess what? I have enough info for an Alive 4. I really do. I don't know when I'll be able to do Alive 4, when I'll be able to afford to do Alive 4. Because I still have to get all my money back, oh my God, for the Prisoner of Fame. So I'm not sure. I might have to release Prisoner of Fame by myself, because sometimes what you get contracts and they don't want to give you any money up front, and then they lock your project up and they put it on the shelf and you've just given them control of your project for absolutely nothing. So I'm not going to do that kind of deal. Even if they promise me $1 trillion, if it's an out clause where they can shelve it, then it doesn't matter. It's just fool's gold, which I don't go for. So I might have to release Prisoner of Fame myself. You guys, I can't wait for you guys to see the short film. I really, really can't. I'm hoping for a deal, but it might not happen. But, you know, whichever way it goes, I want to show it to you guys because I'm so proud of it, okay? So you guys know that you buy my products, I usually reinvest the money into new Michael products, right? How many Michael documentaries have I done now? I did Behind the Scenes at the Michael Jackson Trial, which was renamed Michael Jackson Trial and Triumph. Then I did a Live 1, and then I did a Live 2, and then I did a Live 3. Oh, let me go back. I did Suicide e-movie book. I did that too. I did the True Talk TV shows, and now I've done Prisoner of Fame and Michael Jackson, and hopefully I'll be able to do Michael Jackson Alive 4, Michael Jackson The Quagmire. Oh, because that would be so good. So anyway, guys, if you haven't watched, please do on Vimeo or order your DVD, because you know I put the money right back into Michael projects for you guys. So anyway, I love you guys, and I will see you guys next time, okay? I'll try to do a video tomorrow or the next day, but you can still see Michael Jackson's Halloween special with Vincent and Victoria and Ichabod, which is a great death hoax clue, and This Place Hotel, which is Heartbreak Hotel. Okay, so I will talk to you guys later. Love you. Bye-bye.